where you are right now. You're inside my closet, so you're basically me when I was 16. Anyway, I decided to do my Funko collection for this video. All of my Funkos are on the shelves, and I don't really like, you know, I was gonna go in order of when I got them, which, with the first couple, I know, but after that, it's kinda like, I got so many at once, I was like, what order do these go in? But I was also gonna go in order of where they are on the shelves, but that would seem, you know, I'd have to move the camera around a lot. So instead, I'm keeping the camera here in a singular place, and I'm going to grab the boxes of the Funkos and then grab that Funko from that box. Whoa! Concepts! Bleh. Anyway, we're gonna start with Castiel. He's in a special box because he was a Hot Topic exclusive, but also I think he came online, probably. So I'm gonna go grab him. Castiel right now is on top of my Heroes of Olympus books in that corner shelf. I got him for Christmas of 2019. Here he is. He has his wings. He's very detailed. His tie is on backwards. He's got fish. I love Castiel. I'm not caught up on Supernatural, so I prefer no spoilers in the comments. I have not watched Supernatural in a long time, but that doesn't mean I appreciate this little guy. But I'm probably gonna rewatch all of Supernatural with my family because my dad really wants to as well. But also, I found out that my dad has the first two seasons of Supernatural on DVD. Like, he actually bought them years ago. And I'm like, dude! So, this is Castiel. He's got his wings. He's very detailed. Gonna place him here. We'll put him back when we get the second one. So, as Castiel, he came in this box. In this Supernatural collection, you can also get Sam, Dean, and Charlie. I remember in an episode of Supernatural, they have Crowley, and it's like a Christmas, but not really. And he's like, Mom, Mom, I got Sam! It was really cute, honestly. It's
getting mighty close. Mom, Mom, I got a Sam!
Also, they do a bunch of stuff with Hot Topic, and, like, their Funkos are just adorable. And I love that this one has wings. Oh, he's got a little belt! But I love that he has his wings. I love that we've canonically decided he has black wings. Like, I love that we were like, yeah, that's how it is. Next person is Poison Ivy. I shall go grab her. I will be right back. Here is Miss Poison Ivy. Now, this is Poison Ivy specifically from the Batman Arkham Asylum video games. She comes on a stand because she has small, tiny feet. The detail with the leaves is really beautiful. They really paid attention to detail with these because they don't really have facial features, but their bodies have so much detail because it's a small doll. Like, you can see the waves in her hair. It's really cool. So she's part of the Batman Arkham Asylum collection. In this collection, you can also get Batman, Joker, Harley Quinn, and Killer Croc. So she's number 55 in this collection. So here she is. I did a review of her, well, an unboxing slash review of her years ago. I will not put a link to that in the description below. But I will put a link to my collections playlist and my Calico Critters collection, which are all right there. Look at them, they're adorable. I haven't gotten any new ones, but in time this video has come out, so thank God, because I am insane with that. But here she is, Miss Poison Ivy. She looks really pretty. I got her years ago. She was one of the earliest Funkos I ever got. So that's really fun to, you know, look back on. Next we have Coraline. Okay, let's go grab her. Oh, we need to put Poison Ivy back. I'm doing, like, a walking thing. I need the exercise, as you can see from my body. Okay. It's Coraline. So, she is actually a Hot Topic exclusive. I got her for my birthday in 2019. So, in this collection, we have Coraline with her cat, Coraline in the raincoat, the Coraline doll, Mr. Bobinski with the mouse, and the other mother. This is Coraline in her raincoat. She is very glittery. which I love. She's got her little freckles. She's very sparkly. This stand falls off very easily. So that's something I worry about. Where she is on the shelf. Poison Ivy is between my Sherlock Holmes collection and my fairy tale books. And Coraline is between my Fault in Our Stars book and Alice in Wonderland, because I feel like her story is a very big Alice in Wonderland kind of story, just really, really dark. Really, really dark. This is a dark story. But yeah, I got her for my birthday. She's really cute, and her stand's a little bit broken. Oh, suddenly it's fixed. Maybe I wasn't putting it on correctly. Woohoo! She's okay now. I love her hair. And then last in these four, because we're doing it in whatever order we can, we have Piglet. So let's go grab Piglet. This is Christmas themed Piglet. Oh my god, look at him. He's adorable. I got him from, I think, Barnes & Noble. So he is between my Fairy Tales book and my Fault in Our Stars book. So he's on the shelf with Coraline and Poison Ivy. These three are on the same shelf. Castiel's on a different shelf. So look at him. He's got a little Christmas present and a scarf and a little Santa, and he's so cute. In this collection, this is the Disney Christmas collection, you can get Mickey Mouse, Minnie Mouse, Winnie the Pooh, or Piglet. I really want Winnie the Pooh, but Piglet is honestly my favorite character in the Winnie the Pooh characters because he has anxiety. And he's got a little smile on his face. They usually don't have mouths, but he gets a little smile, which I think is really cute. But the attention to detail, look at this little present. It's so cute. It's not focusing very well. There we go. He's just adorable. So we're gonna put that back. He did not come with a stand. Now, just to let you guys know, when you buy Funkos, if you get the ones with stands, use them because they do fall down. Funkos do fall down a lot, especially where I have in places like Bookstoppers. Books fall down, knock them over, they could get damaged. I will show you that soon in one of them. So I'm going to put all these boxes back where they were. First things first, Lisa Simpson. Okay, we're going to go grab her now. She is specifically placed in front of all of my books that have female authors. She is between my Circe book by Madeline Miller and Grips Fairy Tales. And then the books behind her are The Song of Achilles, also by Madeline Miller, Simon vs. the Homo Sapiens Agenda, and Bad Girls Don't Die. All of those books are by women except for the Grimm Fairy Tales. I feel like she'd still appreciate Grimm Fairy Tales. I love Lisa Simpson. I grew up with The Simpsons. I really did. So I'm just going to place her right here. No, I'm not. Okay. So in this collection for Simpsons, we get Radioactive Man, Lisa with her saxophone, Maggie Simpson, Grandpa Simpson, Mo Sizlak, Mr. Burns, and Bartman. I do know they also have Homer, but I think that's part of a continuation because they have nearly all the Simpsons characters available. But here's Lisa. I got her at Hot Topic. She's probably my favorite character in The Simpsons. I grew up with The Simpsons. It was my favorite cartoon growing up. Here's her saxophone. She's got her necklace. She's got her character spiky hair, eyelashes. She looks adorable, and she does need a stand because she has the big feet, so she's fine standing by herself. So that's Lisa. Next we have Harry Potter. Harry Potter.
I've been watching Harry Potter, so
probably Harry Potter?
Harry Potter, yeah.
So he is actually above my Harry Potter collection. He's not on the shelf with it. Because I couldn't fit him. But he is between my book From What I Remember and the Circe book. And behind him is a book of Shakespeare's sonnets. A book about Wicca, because duh, he's a wizard. And the 1 Second After novel, which is a novel that's a post-apocalyptic novel. Anyway, this is Harry Potter. And he is in his Prisoner of Azkaban pajamas when he's going through the hallways looking for Peter Pettigrew / Sirius Black with his little wand and Marauder's map, and the Marauder's map is drawing on it, and your glasses, his scar, his hair should be spikier than this. He looks like a page boy. Why did they do him so dirty? Anyway, in this collection, this is specifically the Prisoner of Azkaban collection. Well, there's some extras. So you have Harry Potter in his Prisoner of Azkaban outfit. We have Hermione Granger in her Prisoner of Azkaban outfit, which is her pink sweatshirt, jeans. Ron in his outfit, he's holding a little bit of Peter Pettigrew / Scabbers. Remus Lupin, Ginny Weasley, Luna Lovegood, and Peter Pettigrew. I would love to get Remus Lupin for my friend, who actually cosplays as Remus. I wish they had more James Potter representation. But here he is, Mr. Harry Potter. I don't know why I'm saying it like that, it's kind of funny. But yes, this is Harry. And I love him very much, and he's one of my favorites. He's very cute. He's very sturdy, so he stands by himself. So you don't need to stand. He's very sturdy. So that's Harry Potter. I need to stop pronouncing it like that, because it doesn't sound like a word anymore. So we're going to put this little guy back where he belongs. After we get this one, this is Stevani from Steven Universe. I will be right back. This is from the Steven Universe collection of Funkos, which is a big collection. So, you can get Steven, you can get Garnet, you can get Amethyst, you can get Pearl, you can get Connie, you can get Peridot, you can get Rose Quartz, you can get Lapis, you can get Lonnie, Lion, but Stevani is a Hot Topic exclusive, okay? You can't get her anywhere else. So here she is in all her glory. She's probably my favorite character from Steven Universe. I am not caught up, so don't be telling me all of this spoiler stuff that I already see online all the time. I love her. I love that we have non-binary representation. She's here with her Rose Quartz sword, Steven's shield. Oh no, she fell off the stand. She comes with a stand because she actually comes barefoot. She's not wearing the flip-flops. And she's got her bracelets on, and her hair is so big, and she's a big doll. She's probably the biggest Funko I have because she is so tall in the show. They were like, we want to make sure she's proportioned correctly. We got her shorts, we got her shirt, we got her gem, and she looks so cool and badass, and she has that smirk on her face. but I love her. I love Stevani. She's my favorite character. So, Stevani, placement. On the shelf, she is in front of my Monster High books. I don't know why I put her there. I just felt like she should be there. I don't know why. I just had this feeling she belonged there. So I'm going to put her box down there. So we're going to put her back, and then we're going to... We have Yuri from Yuri on Ice. No, this is Victor. I keep on getting that confused. I feel like a fake fan. I'm not. I swear I'm a fan. And I swear, okay. Here is Victor. This is specifically young Victor with his long ponytail and his rose crown and his outfit, and he's skating, so he comes with a stand so he can be in his pose. So in this collection, the Yuri on Ice collection, you can get Yuri, Victor, Yuri, or young Victor. There's four in this collection. So I have young Vita, because he's so pretty, and he was the one that was available, and he's so pretty. I'm trying my best to do Russian, but it's not working. Or maybe it is. I don't know. I know how to do Russian accent. Or is this Polish? It's the same. That is offensive. Russian. Nope, that's Stitch. Russian. Mother Russia. Russian. Anyway, this is Victor. Young Victor. He looks so cute. And I love him. He's so pretty. He's just a pretty, pretty boy. He is a pretty boy. He's such a pretty boy. He's a pretty little boy. I love him. He's so pretty. He's like. Then we have Sherlock Holmes. This is a big collection that I didn't know about until I looked at the back of this box. Sherlock. Oh, Victor's placement. Okay, let me find out where he is. Got it. So Victor is between my Mortal Danger book and From What I Remember novel. He is in front of the book thief, F. Scott Fitzgerald, The Great Gatsby, a book about fairies, and Langston Hughes' poems. I don't know where he is in that selection, I just put him there. But this is Sherlock specifically with his skull for Hamlet. So let's explain the Sherlock collection. Sherlock Holmes, Dr. John Watson, Jim Moriarty, Mycroft Holmes, Ivy Dadler. You can get Sherlock with a violin, Sherlock with a skull, Sherlock with the deer stalker hat, Sherlock with our apple, or Moriarty with crown. This is a big collection that I didn't know about. This was specifically a Hot Topic exclusive I got many years ago for a birthday a long time ago. But look at him, he's so cute! Well, he's not cute, he's stern. He is Sherlock. He has his skull, his shirt is the way he is. Is everyone else disappointed with season 4? I didn't get it. He is between. He's actually next to the Sherlock Holmes collection I have. And then he's next to the Famous Last Words book that I got. It's a book of people's famous last words. And I have a joke I will show you later that you should know about. But here he is, Mr. Sherlock. He looks very debonair. We have Katya!
Катерина Петровна Замолочикова. But you're dead, just calls me Katya.
Here is Katya.
My country.
You're a little bit garbage.
I'm a little bit garbage. I have to suck the life out of this rubber chicken. I had some shit. We're all gonna die up there. I opened my mouth for dicks and balls.
Anyway, this is Katya. On my shelf, she is next to my The Darkest Minds novel, which got turned into a movie. My Oscar Wilde collection, my two Shakespeare plays, which are Macbeth and A Midsummer Night's Dream. So here she is. Now, I got her online. She is a Hot Topic exclusive. Ekaterina Petrovna Zamolochikova, but your dad just calls me Katya. I think in this collection, you can get Jinx Monsoon, Sharon Needles, RuPaul, and Trixie Mattel. I was lucky to get Katya what I did. Now, as you can see, her makeup is a little bit bad. Alaska would approve. And her nails aren't awesome. But the detail on her outfit is great. This was the outfit she walked into the workroom with in season 7. I can't read Russian, so I don't know what this says. But yes, this is Katya. She's a Hot Topic exclusive. I got her online. Her hat is like bumpy, so it like looks like the texture. She's got the star right there, the hammer and sickle. This outfit is really detailed. Like, they really nailed it on the detail with the outfit, the original outfit. It's just her makeup, the lipstick specifically, they smudged it. I don't know how. And the nails are, they're okay. It's just a little bit of paint smudging. But she looks great either way. She looks really cool. So Katya's gonna go back. Oh, Katya, by the way, came with a stand because she's wearing heels. What do you expect? Never mind, she hardly ever wears heels. She doesn't wear heels, but she just, So let's grab Wheezy from Toy Story. Specifically, Toy Story 2, in front of my other Monster High books. But here's Wheezy from Toy Story 2 with his microphone. So in the Toy Story collection, you can get Woody, Buzz Lightyear, Ham, Rex, Slinky Dog, Bo Peep, Mrs. Nesbitt, Wheezy, and Bullseye. This is not a Hot Topic exclusive, so you can get them. I've seen them in Barnes & Noble as well. I would love Mrs. Nesbitt. I would also love a Ham, all of them. But my collection is officially ended. I've stopped collecting Funkos now because I have as many as I need. I don't really need to put any anywhere else. But this is Wheezy. He's a basic looking one, but still, that's the whole point. It looks like he has a speaker, the squeaker in his mouth. He doesn't need a stand. He stands by himself. He's got the microphone. He looks like when he was singing at the end of Toy Story 2. He's kind of dusty, but that makes a lot of sense. I think that's added on looking dust, honestly, which is really cool, or it's just dusty. I don't know. But yes, he is in front of my Monster High books and next to my Libra candle. Don't know why, he just fit there, and I thought he looked good there. Next, we have Britney Spears. I just love that there's a Funko of Britney Spears. Her placement is in front of my Trials of Apollo novels, because you know Apollo's made a reference to her at some point. So I think she's a standalone in her collection. She's part of the musician's collection, I think, but it doesn't really say if there's anyone else in here. This is a Barnes & Noble exclusive, so you can only get her at Barnes & Noble. And this is her at the VMAs, I don't know what year, but she's performing I'm a Slave for You, and she's going, I'm a slave for you. That was too good. I'm just kidding. That was bad. Anyway. She's got a little mic, her hair, her costume, the exact replica. She's got the snake, and she comes with a stand because she's barefoot. But she's in front of Mr. Trials of Apollo because it just makes sense to put her there, considering he's probably made a reference to her in at least one of the books. So there's Miss Britney Spears. This is Barnes & Noble exclusive. You can't get her anywhere else. I was really happy when I got her because, like, she's Britney Spears. Like, if they had a Lady Gaga Funko, oh my god, I'd shit my pants. Next, we have Raphael from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Controversial opinion, but we'll get into it. This little guy is in front of my Percy Jackson novels. And he fell! So, this box has been damaged because I didn't know how to open it. So, here's the box, Raphael. In the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles collection, you got Donatello, Raphael, Michelangelo, Leonardo, Splinter, and Shredder. Raphael, his face looks like this, so he actually has teeth when most of the time they don't have mouths. They all have specific facial features for their characters. He's holding his, are these called katanas? I don't know anything about martial arts. I don't know anything about ninjas. He's in front of my Percy Jackson books. He's got his red mask. He's got his angry face. He's my favorite Ninja Turtle out of all of them, because, like, I feel like him being angry makes a lot of sense. Because I think he's technically the oldest out of all of them. So he's like, oh, it makes sense. I become the leader before Leonardo does. But then Splinter's like, you have anger. And he's like, I'm not angry. I'm just sick of your bullshit. And also, he's the one that becomes friends with April first. I think in every iteration, he meets April before the rest of them, I think. I think that's how it works, is he meets April first. Which, you know, that's a thing that happened. Look at him. He's not the oldest Funko I have, but he's one of the oldest. He's the second Funko I ever got. And I love him. Look at him. He's got his feet. He's really funny looking. He looks great on the shelf, though, with Percy Jackson. It makes a lot of sense that he's there. They probably made a reference to Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles at least once in those books, knowing Percy. Percy and his ass. Knowing him. Let me move this paper out of the way. Sorry about that. That's just a sign I have. Bulbasaur! I got really excited because it's Bulbasaur, man. Okay, Bulbasaur is in a place. about this little guy? Because he's the only one that's in this position, and he's rather big. I had to put him in a specific section, which is in front of all of my scripts for theater. So here's Bulbasaur. It doesn't say what else comes in this collection, but I've seen a Charmander a couple of times and a Squirtle. I don't think they have a Pikachu, but I know they have a Charmander and a Squirtle. And here's Bulbasaur. They're the originals. So these guys, you plant his little bulb. I'm gonna fucking pee. He's got a new face. He's just so cute. He's like, I never played Pokemon as a kid, but I knew some things about Pokemon. He's like my favorite because he's so freaking cute. And he's just so cute. I have another Bulbasaur, which is a stuffed animal of Bulbasaur, and he has a little Santa hat on. So here he is. He's in his little spot, and he just looks really cute there. And I appreciate him very much. For being a good little pal. And he's so cute! I just want to give him a hug every day. So we got three left. We have Gerard Way. is between The Amazing Book is Not on Fire by Dan and Phil, and also The Famous Last Words book. Because there's an MCR song called Famous Last Words, and that's why I put him there. But this Gerard Way, so this collection is a Hot Topic exclusive, and there's three ones, so you could get Black Parade, Revenge, or this is the one with the red tie. I like this one the most, because this is the I'm Not Okay video, I think. Yeah. My boyfriend would know more because he's a bigger MCR stan than me. And so is my friend Amelia. I wasn't able to go to the reunion, cried about it, because I live on the East Coast. But we're in the roaring 20s, motherfucker. We're back. Ow. Anyway, this is Gerard Way. He looks very cute. Very stylish. He's got his hands and prick. He looks really cool. And if anyone gets mean about him gaining weight, I'll punch your face. Because honestly, him gaining weight was healthier than him staying skinny all the time because y'all made him tour so much and he just didn't stop working and now he can finally relax, write comic books, and take care of his daughter. So, you if you make fun of his weight, okay? You. He's old. He's allowed to be old. Stop saying he can't be old. He's old now. Stop it. He's old. I'm sorry you can't Gerard Way anymore. He's old. Then we have Dobby. This is Dobby.
Master has presented Dobby with a sock. Dobby is a free elf.
Think the fuck not.
Look at it. This is Dobby. This is specifically the Chamber of Secrets collection. I think. Yeah, this is the Chamber of Secrets / Philosopher's Stone collection. But mainly Chamber of Secrets. Yeah. Well, there's some other ones, but mainly Chamber of Secrets, characters. Plus, he's got his little spark of magic. So, in this collection, you have Ron Weasley with his howler. Sirius Black is the dog. You have the Bloody Baron, Dobby, Hedwig, Hermione Granger, Rubius Hagrid, and Harry Potter. Hermione Granger is a cat. And Harry Potter's in pajamas with his arm broken. Because, yep, he's in his outfit, but he doesn't have the sock and that ruins it. Give him a fucking sock, mate. It'd be cute. Anyway, look at him. He's all wrinkly and he's an elf and he's got a little bit of magic and he's really small, but his ears are huge. So it took me forever to find somewhere to put him. because his ears are so big, he doesn't fit between any of the books. So I had to put him in a corner. So he's in front of the Ever After High books, because I couldn't put him next to Harry Potter. Because he didn't make sense there, and I couldn't fit him there, so I didn't put him there. Okay? Sorry about it, but not sorry about it. Master's giving Dobby his sock. Dobby is free. Then we have the first Funko I ever got. Mr. Loki! Bow, 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 bow. Mr. Loki in front of... This makes a lot more sense when you see it. This little guy is in front of the Magnus Chase collection, which is all about Norse guys. But look at this. He's a bobblehead! He's the last bobblehead! But look at him! I think he's one of the last bobbleheads they ever made. Because they used to be just bobbleheads, and then they stopped being bobbleheads because the springs would get caught and all sorts of things. Now he has a crack in his face because he'd fall off the shelf a lot and hit stuff, such as the TV stand. He'd hit the floor, he'd hit the TV, so his face eventually cracked slightly. This is his Thor the Dark World outfit, which we don't like. But in this collection, you could get Thor, Loki, the Dark Elf, or Thor with the helmet. Thor the Dark World was not a good movie. You're dead, by the way. I just want to explain how many of these people are dead. Oh, God. How many of these... Dobby's dead. You're dead. Anyone else dead? I don't know if Castiel is, because I'm not caught up. But if he does officially die, I'm going to cancel the show. I'm going to call them and go, yeah, we don't want any more episodes. We don't want any more. Like, we don't even care if this is the final season. Once you kill Cass, you can't come back from that. You will lose an entire fan base. They did at the beginning of season 13 because they killed Cass. Or was it season 12? It was the beginning of season 12. Or 13. 13. 13. They killed Kaz. And, well, they killed Kaz at the end of season 12. And everyone, like, rioted and everyone got really upset. And a lot of people stopped watching the show because they didn't know he was going to come back. Spoiler alert. If you haven't been caught up for a long time. I haven't. All I know is that Jack's dead. Mary's dead. Everyone's dead! And now people are coming back, and I don't know what it means, and Chuck's a dick, and... anyway, this is Loki. I should have talked about this during Supernatural. Anyway, beep 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 beep. Yeah, he's a bobblehead, and he shakes... I do this... not that often, but I like shaking it. But yeah, this is Loki, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video. This is my latest collection video. I hope you guys like these collection videos, because I do have a lot of fun making them, and I do have a lot of collections I can do. I don't know what I could do next. I could do my CD collection, a choker collection. That'd be interesting. No, it wouldn't. I could do my hat collection. A lot of things I could do collections of. But thank you guys so much for watching. Like this video if you thought it was interesting. Subscribe for more collection videos in the future. Comment what videos I should make next. What collection videos I should make next. Hit the notification bell for a new video every Saturday/Sunday. Thank you for watching my Zodiac makeup look and my Calico Critters collection video. I got two collection videos coming at you at once, so you can both enjoy, you can enjoy all of those right now when this video comes out. And thank you guys so much for watching, and follow the social media links in the description below. Instagram, Snapchat, TikTok, Pinterest, Tumblr, fandom blog, other blog, Twitter, and I'll see you guys next time. Woo! I can't stop.